1945.
It was obvious that soon technology would develop to the point where it would lead to terminal disaster. Immediately after the Trump election, late January this year, the clock was moved again to 2.5 minutes to midnight, closest to spin since 53. So there's the two existential threats that we've created. In the case of nuclear war, maybe wipe us out. In case of environmental catastrophe, severe impact. And then a third thing happened. Around the 70s, human intelligence dedicated itself to eliminating, or at least weakening, the main barrier against the threats. It's called neoliberalism.
We deregulated the airlines. We deregulated the trucking industry. We deregulated financial institutions. We decontrolled oil and natural gas prices. And we negotiated lower trade barriers throughout the world to get rid of needless and burdensome federal regulations.
I'm not in favor of fairness. I'm in favor of freedom. And freedom is not fairness. Fairness means somebody has to decide what's fair.
But freedom means subordination to the decisions of concentrated, unaccountable private power. That's what it means. The institutions of governance or other kinds of association that could allow people to participate in decision making, those are systematically weakened. Margaret Thatcher said it rather nicely in her aphorism about there is no society, only individuals. That's neoliberalism. We destroy, or at least undermine, the governing mechanisms in which people, at least in principle, can participate to the extent the society is democratic. So weaken them, undermine unions, other forms of association, leave a sack of potatoes, and meanwhile transfer decisions to unaccountable private power, all in the rhetoric of freedom.